have filed a complaint in Etowah County alleging political conspiracy, among other claims, against defendants Richard Hagedorn, Marjorie Lee Corfman, Debbie Wesson Gibson, Beverly Young Nelson, and Tina Turner Johnson. This was filed because the people of Alabama deserve to know the truth. The people of Alabama already know that over $40 million was spent in an attempt to defeat Judge Roy Moore during the special Senate election, and he remained 11 points ahead in the polls. Because $40 million was spent, over $40 million was spent, and he remained ahead in the polls, we intend to show the people of Alabama that a political conspiracy came about to ruin his campaign for Senate and to defame him, defame his character, so that the people of Alabama would not vote for him in the election. The people I list as defendants all seem to have common ties to one another, common ties to the Democratic Party, and above all, a political goal in the end, not to see Judge Roy Moore be seated as a senator for Alabama. What we intend to show is that Judge Moore is innocent of these allegations. And it's a sad state of affairs that women can make allegations with no evidence whatsoever and ruin someone's life, ruin someone's reputation, and destroy a stellar career. Judge was the Deputy District Attorney of Etowah County. He was Circuit Court Judge. He was two-time Chief Justice of our Alabama Supreme Court. And not one time did any impropriety come up regarding any conduct, regarding any sexual impropriety. Judge Moore's reputation was seamless and was spotless. 32 days before the election, 32 days, there were allegations that were malicious and they were false. And it's our position, and we tend to show that they were made for no other reason than to destroy his character and ruin his chances in the special election. There were 9 women who made allegations of sexual misconduct. It's not true. There were 3 women, and those 3 women are listed in this complaint. Those 3 women, in concert with others, planned this, planned the timing of their allegations in order to hurt Judge Moore, fix his character, and his campaign. So we intend to show now the people of Alabama that that was not true. We want to show you that the character that we've known him his whole life is the true Judge Moore. He's of good moral standing. He's of good moral character. And that he did not do these things. The worst thing you can do to someone is slap a label of them that they're a pedophile. And that's exactly what happened here. No one should raise an eyebrow. 32 days before a special election, if you look at someone who has been abused or someone who's been sexually traumatized, I would think the last thing they would do is run to the Washington Post. So we have someone who finally, after all these years, wants to speak, and she wants to speak nationally. They don't buy it. So you look at the timing and the context. And the way these allegations came out, they were timed just right. Within days of each other, these allegations came out. So we intend to look at the timing and the context. We intend to look at how these people are connected. And we intend to, we have a lot of research, we have a lot of discovery to do. We've done a lot already, or this wouldn't have been filed. But I think given the circumstances, given the allegations that were made, given the people involved, we think the people of Etowah County will see clear that is the conspiracy and that these allegations were false.
Do you intend it?
Well, I think
Lee Corfman was the first one, correct?
So she is the first.
Your question was that she came out because other allegations had come out?
That's I don't want to be too specific about it, because but this is a time and place in which we live, and I think that the women were saying that far from conspiracy, they came forward of their own volition, thinking this was a better time to make this claim.
30 days before the special election, Judge has run for public office on multiple occasions, and only this time, this was the right time. I think that's very suspect. And again, she made no attempt whatsoever to try to reach out to Judge Moore in a private setting. You know, if someone who especially abuses a child, I would think the last thing they want to do is have their face plastered all over commercials during a political season. And certainly, I would think, I would imagine, that she gave consent to those.
To that effect?
We believe she's gotten both. I think more will come out as this lawsuit progresses.
Is your client prepared to be deposed and prepared to go through under oath in this deposition, in this defamation lawsuit?
Absolutely.
There's no concerns at all about merit of their allegations?
Well, we're going to comply with the rules of civil procedure when it comes to discovery and depositions and the like. There are no depositions in this case that he's been noticed for.
Might we be able to hear from the judge? It seems like yes.
You might. Richard's attorney, we're here prepared to go through this. How many of you have seen the complaint?
Not yet.
Well, the complaint's going to answer a lot of your questions. There's an old saying, deep in the blind squirrel, you find an acre once in a while. You've heard that. I'm not accusing the press of being blind. I'm not accusing the press of not knowing what's going on. But I'll tell you this, if you read the complaint, you're going to see a political conspiracy. And even the press should be able to see a political conspiracy, which is what it is. We've got it documented. I'm prepared to go through depositions. I've taken a lie detector test. Have you heard anybody else taking a lie detector test? I don't think so. We're saying that this has been warped by the press so that people have been blinded and cannot see the truth. But unfortunately, a lot of people in Alabama did. 650-something thousand saw the proof, the truth, and voted for me in this election. Etowah County itself went nearly 60% for me in this election. This is where I came up. This is where I practiced law. And some of these people were before my court. Some of them were clients or relation to clients. There's a lot to be known. You'll have to read the complaint. Yet we're prepared to go through depositions. The question is, are they?
Is this the reason why there was no formal concession on your part, Judge?
There's no formal concession.
You never said the words "I concede" after
that,
you lost.
That belongs to the race. That has something not to do with this complaint and with the allegations brought against you.
And for those,
find out the truth and the conspiracy. What we've documented in this complaint will show the people of Alabama that these people knew what they were doing. They set it out. They described what they were going to do. They did it, and they bragged about doing it after.
And to those who question your time now, that perhaps you're not as in the spotlight as much as you were back in November and December. You were one of the most famous men in the nation back then, and now your time is sort of, the spotlight has sort of moved on. So to those that question your timing of your press conference and this announcement.
I think it's altogether proper to bring this case at this time and bring it in Etowah County to show where this conspiracy went on. It's taken a lot of time to put together the facts that we've got, and we'll show it in this trial.
Towards the end of those 32 days, I believe you stopped answering any questions regarding these allegations specifically. Can you speak to that and why it is that now you're willing to start
speaking?
But why wait? I think that's the question. Why not?
Read the complaint.
Is there a copy that you could perhaps provide us, since we are all sort of...
It's online. It's online. I've got a copy here, but that's not the final one. It's a copy.
Jeff, can you speak personally to what you've been going through, I guess, these last few months? Your attorney speaks eloquently about a reputation that has been hampered, if not destroyed. Can you say a little bit personally about what's been going on in your mind these last few months?
Well, I think the complaint will cover the fact that it's been very difficult for our family. It's been very difficult for my wife. And that's a point here. We've got more than one, two women making complaints. We've got people on the other side who are women also and have suffered because of these false complaints. We're going to make it very clear in this case.
Not even going.
No.
Are you still seeking additional funds from the public? You've been asking multiple times through the course of the last few months.
The people on the other side of this case are attorneys from San Francisco, Washington, D.C., and Birmingham, Alabama. You think it's not political when three attorneys from San Francisco come here to Alabama on the case?
Does this have anything?
We have to raise money, yes.
Does this have anything to do with the political action committee that we found out later was basically backed by the Democratic Party, saying that if you vote for Judge Ron Moore, people will find out you're
voting
for him?
That's a very good question. This case does not. Related cases would have that implication, but this case, I'm a judge.
And what about the change of venue request? I'm a little confused. Is that still pending with respect to the per defamation?
There is a mandamus action for the Alabama Supreme Court about change of venue from where Mrs. Corcoran filed in Montgomery. We think the proper venue is here. This is where all the witnesses are. This is where all the facts are. This is where Mrs. Corcoran's from. One must wonder why she wants to file in Montgomery and not Nettawal County, where she's well known. We think this is the proper venue. In fact, as Mrs. Isaac has said, this is the only place this case can be filed. Three of the defendants are from Nettawal County. One is from Calhoun County, contiguous, and others from Florida, who used to be in Nettawal County. Both plaintiffs were in Nettawal County. The tort occurred in Nettawal County.
Scintilla of truth to any of these allegations made by the three named folks or six others who have come forward that you
come
and your attorneys
forward
dispute.
For what? You all continue. What did they come forward as? Sexual misconduct?
That's correct.
No. Name one that's come forward with sexual misconduct other than these three. One of these three it was a sexual misconduct.
All right, well, let's stick to the three then. You maintain there's absolutely no truth to any of these allegations whatsoever.
I never knew them. There's no truth to them.
Never knew these people at all.
Never know them. That one was before my court and said that she had never come back before me and she appeared before my court. I didn't know her then. I don't know her now.
Your supporters. What are some of the things that you were hearing and some of the questions they have for those that are accusing you?
I'm fueled by the truth. The truth is laid out in very plain paragraphs in the complaint that was filed today. Unfortunately, you didn't have it. You don't have it now. But when you read it, you'll see it was about politics from the beginning. It was Isaac. Isaac pointed out 32 days after 70 years. That should raise your attention. Look at the nature of the allegations. We're going to bring it to the people of Alabama.